Pick up the 1740 turn here at Schoengrabern. See, the dusk is beginning. The main effect is that artillery ranges and values will be diminished. Not a lot of cavalry activity yet, since we're stuck in the vineyard. We begin with the French half of the turn. We see a massive amount of French reinforcements waiting to enter. So we're going to roll some dice left to right and see if we can get somebody to come to the aid. Finally. Those fellows will arrive with Legrand. See if the grenadiers will show up. That regiment does, and then the other one does not. Boy. Guys don't want to show up. We'll give them a chance to come back next turn. Now we have three regiments of cavalry. And one regiment passes his roll. The 21st, so we'll have them arriving, and the other ones will stick back on the turn track and wait for them to arrive next turn. Now we move down to the east. We have two regiments previously waiting and one new one. So 64th is still out. 40th does roll. He will appear this turn. We'll roll once more for the 88th. And he does not. He rolls a 2. So we got a smattering of French reinforcements. Still a large number pending. That's kind of the poorest showing of French arrival that I've had in this game so far. So we'll get started with the French movement phase here. The French cavalry are in the mired in the vineyard, so there's no charges. We'll bring the 40th on here. We sort of stop them right there. Can't get very far into the vineyard now anyway. We'll stick here on the east side. Try to get some movement out of the light infantry here. We're going to get them right in position. We're running out of time. We've made very poor progress. The French are going to be throwing themselves at the Russians this turn. They're probably going to be able to concentrate pretty heavily on that guy, so they should be able to make progress on the east side. Here in the center we have the grenadiers and that cavalry. We'll get started with the grenadiers. So just moving in column across the ford onto the path in the vineyard. And I did that wrong. That's two movement points to move into the vineyard. So I think I will move that fella here and leave that one there. That gets us back on track. Now we have this cavalry regiment. He probably is going to go to the east here to try to support the flank move by Suchet. We'll just kind of get him move in that direction. I'm going to run Murat's aide over to that routed battalion that likely should have run off the board, but I kept them there and give them a chance to rally. We have that artillery, which is now kind of pointless there on the ridge, now that the dusk has settled, they won't be able to really reach anyone with their reduced range. So we're going to try to limber them up. Nope, neither one of those guys limbered. We have the two that are already limbered, so we'll just probably start moving them, try to get them into some supporting position. Meanwhile, we have another grenadier. We've got one more hex. We can move three movement points into the vineyard. We'll move three there, four, and one more across the ford. For five, I think we can get one more underneath those grenadiers. Meanwhile, we have some skirmishers here. I'm going to try to turn them around. Get them engaged. Try to do some damage. Since they're in the vineyard, they're not going to get very far, but now we're going to move here to the west side. We have a line of reinforcements coming in. We'll just start slowly moving them up. I really want to try to get them onto the flanks. Try to give the Russians as much trouble as we can on this side. We have Legrand there. I think I'll move him one hex and try to engage that battalion. Then, a little further afield, we have the cavalry kind of sitting here. Not a good position to melee anyone. So I think we're just going to try to run him. Oops. Three hexes, five moving points apiece. And conveniently, I've forgotten what these obscured markers are obscuring, so that helps keep the game fresh. I think that'll conclude the movement for this turn. Let's move on to fire phases. This is the Russian defensive fire phase on the east side. We basically have two battalions in contact. That one is seriously depleted, so you have a very... both of them are. So we have a very small likelihood of inflicting any casualties, but we'll throw the dice. And they both were fairly low, so no casualties there. So now towards the center, we have several points of contact, so we'll just start throwing dice, see if we can make some casualties. This guy is a four. That I know is a grenadier in line in the clear there, that little area. So, yeah, not quite high enough. So I threw four sets of dice and no casualties in the center. We have one more in frame. Let's go ahead and hit that one. We rolled a nice high 62 according to our modified rules. that's going to be a casualty. So this French light infantry battalion has taken a beating. Now he has a morale of 22. We've thrown a morale dice of 12. So that is a disorder, which seems appropriate when you've lost that much effectiveness. And finally, here on the west side, we have a couple of battalions in contact. So that was a very high roll on those skirmishers, and will affect a casualty. It's first casualty, so no morale checks. Now we have one more shot and a low number. So that concludes the defensive fire for the Russians. Let's just continue on with the French. We're going to fire the full force of that light infantry battalion against those grenadiers. And we rolled a nice high number of 64. That should be a casualty. Second casualty on those grenadiers, so they will check morale. And ooh, we rolled snake eyes, so that is a disorder. So the French need a little bit of good luck like that. We'll roll the next shot here. I believe that'll be 1 to 2. We rolled a very high number, a 65. So that will inflict another casualty. No morale check since it's the first one. Still a good thing to do. That'll put us in good position for a melee layer. Let's move to the center. So until those supporting grenadiers get up, we'll be exchanging some musket skirmish fire here, hoping to inflict some casualties. This grenadier is going to fire in line. Rolled a very low number, so no casualties in each of these attacks. Let's look once more at the east. On the east side, we kind of have been able to gang up on these two battalions, so we might be able to inflict a casualty and finish the job there. We roll a dice, 25, that's pretty low. I'm pretty sure we don't have high enough odds to worthy bother with trying to calculate. The second attack is a 51. Since those are both 8, probably 2 shots of 16. And that is going to cause a casualty. That is the third casualty on that guy, so he's gone. And we'll jump the leader. Ulanius. So he's out. So we were inflicting some casualties on the Russians, that's good. But we sort of lost our opportunity for melee there. So now we'll move to the melee phase. So I've marked my assaults. We're going to attempt 3, one in each area of the field. We'll start here on the east. We have 3 increments against 1. Now the French have to make a pre-melee morale check, so that should help them. And we rolled a 31, which is usually pretty safe. Yep, so the French will pass. And they can use 3 increments of their strength in their melee. So it'll be 3/5 of 13 against some very small number. 1/3 of 7. So that will be a 3-to-1 attack. Rolling the dice, we roll a 63, which is enough to cause a disorder, which will cause an increment loss. That'll be the third, and so we now wipe out that battalion. will advance the 34th. And we're done. These grenadiers are going to give another shot across that ford. It's been like the most impregnable fortress so far. So we'll roll our pre-melee morale check. A nice high number, 51, so they should be storming across the ford. The Russians have a 7, 18, and a dice modifier of 5 for the general. So we rolled a very high number of 61 plus the 5. That's a 66. Now that doesn't really make any difference because we're at 2.5 to 1, so that's just a disorder. Since these are premier rules, we disorder 3 hexes. That's what it says, hexes. Lose an increment. And the grenadiers get across the ford. We have one more attack on the west. General Legrand is going to throw his men at that musketeer battalion. Rolls a nice high number of his pre-melee morale check, so he is able to drive home the attack. He can get, let's see, he has 8 increments in this big battalion. He can only use 3 of them. 3/8 of 19. That's against 2/3 of 6, so even I can figure that out. So with Legrand's modifier of 3 plus 3, throw some dice, we get a 35, we add 3 to it. On a 1.5 to 1 attack, that is 1 increment loss for each side. So the Russians will be taken perilously close to destroyed. And the French will lose 1 more increment here. So the French really need some retreats. That wasn't a great outcome, but good enough. That'll conclude the melee phase. We have 2 units we need to try to rally. So we'll go ahead and throw some dice for them. We've got that battalion there. Rolled a nice high number, 61, so they recover. And our last ditch effort to rally that battalion. Eesh, not very good. They are a morale of 26. We rolled a 25. We have a leader value of 2. Not good enough. So they'll remain routed, and we're going to let them route off the map as we should have, and they're gone out of the battle. Murat's aide is going to remain. They don't have to run away with him. I forgot we had 1 disordered light battalion there. We rolled a very poor number, a 13. So disordered and half his increment's gone. Definitely he routes. So we will go ahead and route that guy. See where he ends up. So if I route him down the path, that's pretty fair, I think. He's just at the edge of the map. Didn't have enough movement points to actually enter a cover terrain. So So that should conclude. We have no one to, no readiness to recover, so that should conclude the French half of this turn. Swinging around to the Russian side of things. Apparently dusk truly has fallen as our light source is having some trouble. We see some big gaps opening in the line here on the left. The center is holding, even though that grenadier got across the ford. And the right is looking at some cavalry trying to breach. So that'll be our main goal, to reposition the Russian lines and try to stem the French tide. Let's first move these hussars. That'd be 5. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. We'll set them right there. We have dragoons here. Just trying to put a little block in front of those guys. If we look on the west, we really need to start shifting and retreating, because the Russians are in bad shape here. So we're going to move 2 hexes. 2 hexes. 2 hexes. We're going to kind of leave that little line alone right there. Our Bagration himself is going to try to move forward here and help out that disordered battalion, see if we can get him to rally. Meanwhile, maybe we'll just move that battalion into the groves there. Vineyards, sorry. Into... those Cossacks there that are basically just going to get chewed up. We're just going to run them away. They're Cossacks, that's what they do. We have very little infantry left here. We'll move those guys. In there. Okay, that's where we're going to leave the Russian movement. And we'll pick up the fire phases. Now, if the Russians are doing a bit of a retrograde maneuver, we have a couple of spots in here where the French can try to fire. And these grenadiers are now actually, they're in general order. So they can fire on either side here. We have them fire against this guy in conjunction with those skirmishers. Low number, so the Russians will be safe. Another fire attack here, low number. So now we have one more fire attack, or excuse me, two more over here on the west side, here and here. And low numbers mean no casualties. So we may as well move right into the Russian fires. Throw dice for both those. Again, low numbers. We can shift back to the center. Take a couple shots. those skirmishers. That is probably not a great... We'll check anyway. We rolled a 55, so we need at least a 1 to 1.5, so I'm going to calculate those odds. That's one increment. The Grenadiers, yeah, they're going to be really low. I don't think they can muster 1.5 to 1, so that's a miss. One more shot here. And another miss. And that'll conclude our fires. And the Russians aren't really in a good position to melee in the vineyard here. But we do have this gigantic Hussar regiment against the French Hussars in the vineyard. And these guys are in the clear. Technically, you're only affected by the vineyard when you're in the vineyard. So that's how we're going to interpret the rule and go ahead and make a massive assault on those French Hussars who cannot retreat because they do not have enough movement differential. So the Russians are 58 against 14, except the French can only muster 3 increments. Now technically, I think cavalry in general order is adversely affected their melee, but it's such a huge disparity, we're just going to throw the dice. So it's a 5-to-1 attack, we roll a 24, and that's a disorder. Now defending cavalry in good order, the disorders, retreats 3 hexes and checks morale. So I take that as a good thing for the French. They could have been crushed, but instead, they only pushed back. They have a 16. Our morale dice were a 25, so they're just fine. We will put a... couple of green fatigue markers. This game is small enough that I'm not going to forget. Usually I mark them to make sure they can't recover. And I think that will be our one and only melee. So if the Russians have 2 units, they're going to try to rally this guy here is disordered. Rolled a nice high number, 63. Just going to assume that's going to pass. They're not on a morale level yet. And one more. That last guy is actually going to be helped along by Bagration himself. So he better rally. And he does. So we have no route moves, no cavalry to recover. So that'll conclude the 1740 turn. Just looking at it, the French made some good progress over here. They cleared out the Russians across the stream. Very little is in front of them, and they're finally getting a little bit of help in the form of reinforcements. The Grenadiers in the center made a punch across the ford, but really no big movement. And on the east, no big movement. But on the plus side, the French have a large contingent of infantry moving up. So the hour's getting late. It's going to be really tough for the French to win this game, I think, if they can get through this vineyard. Their huge numbers just will crush the Russians on the other side in this clear territory. So that's what they're hoping for, to get through before nightfall. That's not much, only 2 more turns.